جزى الله بالخيرات عنا أئمة لنا نقلوا القرآن عذبا وسلسالا فمنهم بدور سابعة قد تواسطت سماء العلا والعدل زهرا وكمالا.
My beloved brothers and sisters, inshallah ta'ala, in this episode, I'm going to go into the fourth shubha, the fourth doubt that the non-Muslims and the Orientalists have brought forward regarding the preservation of the Qur'an. This shubha, inshallah ta'ala, is جواز قراءة القرآن بالمعنى. They said that it is permissible, in accordance to your tradition, O Muslims, that the Qur'an can be read based on meaning. That it's not a concept of the words are verbatim, that they are from God like this, from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala like this, the way it is, but you can read the Qur'an based on meaning. As long as the concept is passed on, that's all that matters. And we want to say, reciting the Qur'an based on meaning and changing a word to another word, as long as it has the same meaning, is not a concept we believe in when it comes to the Qur'an. The Qur'an, we believe the wordings have to be left the way that the Prophet recited it, alayhi salatu wasalam. It can't be changed, it cannot be altered. They said, no, we have evidence for this. قُلْ هَاتُوا بُرْهَانَكُمْ إِن كُنْتُمْ صَادِقِينَ. If you're truthful, bring your evidences. They said, our evidence is مَا رَوَاهُ أَبُو دَاوُدٍ مِنْ حَدِيثِ أُبَيْ بْنُ كَعْبٍ. The hadith that's found in Sunan Abi Dawood, that Ubay radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لَيْسَ مِنْهَا إِلَّا شَافٍ كَافٍ إِنْ قُلْتَ سَمِيعًا عَلِيمًا عَزِيزًا حَكِيمًا مَا لَمْ تَخْتِمْ آيَةَ عَذَابٍ بِرَحْمَةٍ أَوْ آيَةَ رَحْمَةٍ بِعَذَابٍ. They brought this hadith. This hadith talks about the ahruf that we spoke about, the mode of recitation of the Qur'an, in which it came down in. And in the siyaq of the hadith, the context of the hadith, in one of its wordings, the Prophet ﷺ, he said, all of those different ahruf, the Prophet ﷺ said, لَيْسَ مِنْهَا إِلَّا شَافٍ. All of them are enough. كَافٍ. They cure, they fulfill the objective, they're enough. In قُلْتَ, if you say, this is where the shubha for them came from, this is where the doubt came to them. إِنْ قُلْتَ سَمِيعًا عَلِيمًا, if you say سَمِيعًا عَلِيمًا, or if you say عَزِيزًا حَكِيمًا, مَا لَمْ تَخْتِمْ, as long as you do not conclude a verse with آيَةَ عَذَابٍ, with the punishment بِرَحْمَةٍ. So the ayah is talking about عذاب, as long as you don't conclude it with a wording of rahmah. And the ayah is talking about عذاب, it's talking about punishment. You cannot conclude with وَاللَّهُ غَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ, for example. Or the ayah is talking about mercy, you cannot conclude it with at the ending of it, that which shows Wallahu Shadidul Iqab, for example, Allah severe in his punishment. You can't, the ayah is talking about mercy. Now, for example, As-sariq wa sariqatu faqta'u aydiyahuma. If the man steals and the woman steals, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what did he say? Chop their hand off. Now, that ayah, it cannot finish with Wallahu Ghafur Rahim, because ayah is talking about a capital punishment. So it's Wallahu Azizul Hakim, correct. So they're saying, look, your hadith is saying this. It's saying that as long as you can finish the ayah with mercy, because it was talking about mercy, and as long as you can finish the ayah that was talking about punishment with that which concludes the meaning of a punishment, we'll say that's a misunderstanding of the hadith, and we'll mention why. They also pushed forward by saying that the Ahmad narrated in his Musnad on the authority of Abu Hurairah that the Prophet ﷺ had said, "Unzila al-Qur'anu 'ala sab'ati ahruf," that the Quran was sent down in seven modes: Aliman, Hakiman, Ghafuran, Rahiman. Aliman, Hakiman, and Ghafuran, Rahiman. So this is, look, Aliman, Hakiman, if you want, you can read. Ghafuran, Rahim, if you want, you can read. It's your choice. We're going to refute this shubha in three ways, inshaAllah ta'ala. The first refutation is that which Ibn Abd al-Barr rahimahullah said. Ibn Abd al-Barr rahimahullah, the great Maghribi scholar, he said أما قوله في هذا الحديث. As for the statement of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم in this hadith where he said سميعا عليما غفورا رحيما عليما حكيما, other than that he said فإنما أراد به ضرب الأم فإنما أراد به ضرب المثل للحروف التي نزل القرآن عليها. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was trying to give an example of the different mode in which the Qur'an came with. أنها معاني متفق مفهومها. That the concept that the verse will be speaking about is what the conclusion will generally be. It doesn't mean you can read whatever you want. The ayah, the Prophet saying here that when the surah, when the ayah is talking about a punishment, it's going to always end with Ghafur Rahim. And when it's talking about a punishment, it's going to end with that which gives the meaning of that, such as Wallahu Shadidul Iqab, something like that. But if the ayah is mercy and it's talking about mercy, it's going to finish with Wallahu Ghafur Rahim and etc. Yani the meaning and the ayah would have the same conclusion. That's what the Prophet saying here. It's not saying you read as you wish. And Ibn Abdul Barr rahimahullah mentions that in his statement. Also, the second refutation on this issue is that the Prophet ﷺ taught the noble companion Al-Bara ibn Azib a dua. And the dua that he taught him was, Allahumma amantu bi kitabika alladhi anzalt wa bi nabiyika alladhi arsalt. The Prophet taught this to Al-Bara ibn Azib, this dua. And Bara said, faradattuha ala al-nabi. I repeated the dua to the Prophet so I could correct my memorization. When I reached the part, Allahumma amantu bi kitabika alladhi anzalt, instead of saying wa bi nabiyika alladhi arsalt, Bara ibn Azib changed the word wa bi nabiyika, he changed it to wa rasulika alladhi arsalt. And then the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam said to him, la wa nabiyika alladhi arsalt. The Prophet said, no, the Prophet, he said wa bi nabiyika alladhi arsalt, change it to that wording, bring it back to what I taught you, the wording I taught you. Bukhari narrated that. So if qira'ati al-hadith, qira'ati al-adhkar bil-ma'na is not allowed, then how would it be allowed for the Qur'an? If the adhkar, you can't read it based on meaning, and you have to take the wording from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, then how would the Qur'an be? And the Prophet is not letting Al-Bara ibn Azib change a wording from a dhikr. How would he let the Sahabas change salawatullahi wa salamun alayhi the Qur'an in whatever way they want? The third refutation on this is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not allow the Prophet to change the wordings of the Qur'an. How can the Prophet give permission to other people to do it? Allah says in the ayah, وَإِذَا تُتْلَى عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتُنَا بَيِّنَاتٍ قَالَ الَّذِينَ لَا يَرْجُونَ لِقَاءَنَا أَتِ بِقُرْآنٍ غَيْرِ هَذَا أَوْ بَدِّلُوا قُلْ مَا يَكُونُ لِي أَنْ أُبَدِّلَهُ مِنْ تِلْقَاءِ نَفْسِي إِنْ أَتَّبِعُ إِلَّا مَا يُوحَى إِلَيَّ إني أخاف إن عصيت ربي عذاب يوم عظيم. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم is saying that I am not allowed to change the wording of the Quran. I am not allowed. I am Nabiullah Muhammad. I am not allowed. إن أتبع إلا ما يوحى. I follow the revelation. I read exactly how it was given to me. So if Nabiullah Muhammad was not allowed, and the ayah saying that he's not allowed to, I can't change it from my own self, how can then we say that the Prophet is giving permission to other people to read the Quran in whatever way they want? Whatever you want, read Ghafur Rahim. If the ayah is talking about mercy, just read Ghafur Rahim. No. The wording, the letters of the Quran are all at-talaqi wal-mushafaha wal-riwaya. The missionaries, the orientalists, they said this is, we still got more. So they brought another shubha to argue their point. They said, okay, what about this hadith? Where do you take this hadith? Which hadith? Ma rawahu Ahmad. That which Imam Ahmad narrated. That the Prophet ﷺ said, Ya Umar, Umar, in al Quran kullahu sawabun, ma lam yuj'al adabun maghfiratan aw maghfiratun adaba. Umar, the Quran, all of it is right. As long as you do not make a ayah that's talking about punishment, you do not make it into a mercy, and an ayah that's talking about mercy and forgiveness, you do not change it to punishment. As long as the meaning is not changed, you can recite it the way you want. That's what they say. That's what the hadith saying according to them. And that's what they say is what is meant by it. I refute them in the following way, inshallah ta'ala. The context of this hadith refutes them, which is this hadith The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said this to Umar at the conflict of him and Hisham ibn Hakim. Umar and Hisham both recited the Qur'an in different ways and they had a conflict amongst themselves. Both of them came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to judge between them. Then the Prophet said to Umar, Ya Umar, innal Qur'ana kullahu sawab. Both of you, your Qur'an, all of it is right. And then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told him that these ayats, the wordings are different, but the meaning is the same. Like it will not happen in any of the qira'at that is talking about punishment and it will conclude with forgiveness. That's what the Prophet was saying to Umar. That both of your recitations is right. And the evidence to show you that both of their recitation, they took it from the Prophet. None of them took their recitation from themselves. And both of them were saying, هَكَذَا عَلَّمَنِيهِ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ. This is how the Prophet taught me. This is how the Prophet taught me. So the Prophet was explaining to Umar, Oh Umar, both of your Qur'ans are right. As long as when you read an ayah, it doesn't change the ending by saying غَفُرُ الرَّحِيمُ when it's talking about adab. Why did the Prophet say that? Because he was saying that your qira'ah and the qira'ah of Hisham ibn Hakim, both of you do not have conflicting recitations. Conflicting recitation. Both of your recitation complements one another. It has the same meaning in it, or it's propagating the same concept. Both of them, which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose. Both of them have the same meaning in it. And the same concepts are in there. Some one might have extra meaning over the other one. No problem. There's no contradiction though. Then they said, okay, we still have more. You think we haven't got enough? We still got more. Hey, what's the extra doubt that you have regarding this? They said, ما رواه الطبراني. أما ما رواه الطبري وابن جرير الطبري narrated. أن أبا درداء. So before they brought a hadith from the Prophet, now they say the Sahabas. We've got athar from the Sahabas. Hey, أبا درداء. أن أبا درداء كان يقرأ رجلا. أبو درداء was reading to a man. كان أبو درداء يقرأ رجلا. أبو درداء was reading to a man. And he was reciting to him, إِنَّ شَجَرَةَ الزَّقُومِ طَعَامُ الْأَثِيمِ. The man recited it and he said, طَعَامُ الْيَتِيمِ. Abu Darda said, say, إِنَّ شَجَرَةَ الزَّقُومِ طَعَامُ الْفَاجِرِ. He said that to him. قُلْ إِنَّ شَجَرَةَ الزَّقُومِ طَعَامُ الْفَاجِرِ. Al-Imam Suyuti mentioned it in his kitab, Ad-Duratul Manthur from Ibn Mas'ud. The same story, but not Abu Darda, rather Ibn Mas'ud. They also used another evidence. They said that Anas ibn Malik, as also Ibn Jarir al-Tabari narrated, that Anas ibn Malik recited the ayah, Inna nashi'at al-layli hiya ashaddu wata'an wa aqwamu qila. He recited it as wa aswabu qila instead of wa aqwamu qila. And some of the people that were sitting there, they said to him, Ya Aba Hamza. We're talking to who? Anas ibn Malik. It's not aswabu qila. It is wa aqwamu qila. And then he said to them, aqwam wa aswabu wa ahya wahid. All of these are the same. Aqwam, aswab, and ahya are all the same. Say, look, here we find sahabas changing wordings. We asked them, do you have any more? They said, yeah, we've got another one. Abi Sirar al-Ghanwi, he was reciting Fajasu Khilal al-Diyar. And he recited it as what? Fahasu. And then it was said to him, Inama huwa Jasu. And then he said, Jasu wa Hasu wahid. That's what he said. Ar-Raddu min wujuh. The refutation to this issue is in three steps, inshallah. The first one is, all of this which you mentioned from the Sahabas are not what it seems from the apparent. Why? Because we have clear-cut evidences, clear-cut from the Qur'an and the Sunnah that do not allow the Qur'an to be changed. I remember recited the ayah, وَإِذَا تُتْلَى عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتُنَا بَيِّنَاتٍ قَالَ الَّذِينَ لَا يَرْجُونَ لِقَاءَ نَأْتِ بِقُرْآنٍ غَيْرِ هَذَا أَوْ بَدِّلُوا قُلْ مَا يَكُونُ لِي أَنْ أُبَدِّلَهُ مِنْ تِلْقَاءِ نَفْسِهِ. We also have the Prophet ﷺ, as I mentioned, that he taught Al-Bara' ibn Azib a dhikr, and he didn't let him change the wording. We also have that Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala said in the Qur'an, وَلَوْ تَقَوَّلَ عَلَيْنَا بَعْضَ الْأَقَاوِيلِ لَأَخَذْنَا مِنْهُ بِالْيَمِينِ ثُمَّ لَقَطَعْنَا مِنْهُ الْوَتِينِ. We have Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying to the Prophet, Ya Rasulu, Balligh ma unzila ilayka min Rabbik. Muhammad, convey what was sent on you, not what you want to make up and add into the religion, but convey what was sent to you. And Muhammad sallallahu alayhi would never want to change it. He would never even go forward to changing it. He's greater and higher than that, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So those evidences divert these evidences or these doubts that you're bringing forward from its apparent point. Number two, the second response is, these recitations that you are bringing forward is maybe and most likely a recitation that they heard from the Prophet, لَكِنَّهَا مِمَّا نُسِخَ فِي الْعَرْضَةِ الْأَخِيرَةِ, but it was abrogated in the final version of the Qur'an when Jibreel came the last Ramadan of the Prophet's life, عليه الصلاة والسلام. It was one of the verses that were abrogated. The evidence for that is, فَجَاسُوا خِلَالَ الدِّيَارِ, reciting as وَحَاسُوا Ibn Abbas and Talha ibn Masrafin, both of them used to recite that. That's important. Also, Al-Imam Al-Qurtubi, he took the opinion that these recitations of Abu Darda and Ibn Mas'ud and Anas ibn Malik and others was tafsir of the ayah. When they were saying, وَأَقْوَى مُقِيلًا as وَأَصْوَى مُقِيلًا, it wasn't that they were reciting the verse as a Qur'an like that, but they were trying to explain what أَقْوَمُ means. It meaning أَصْوَبُ or طَعَامُ الْأَثِيمِ. أَثِيمِ here means الْفَاجِرِ. Ibn Mas'ud was explaining the meaning. And that's what Al-Imam Al-Qurtubi rahimahullah said. وَلَا حُجَّةَ فِي هَذَا لِلْجُهَالِ مِنْ أَهْلِ الزَّيْغِ. There's no evidence in this for these ignorant, deviated people. أَنَّهُ يَجُوزُ إِبْدَالُ الْحَرْفِ مِنَ الْقُرْآنِ بِغَيْرِهِ. That you can change the Qur'an with one word and with another word. لأن ذلك إنما كان من عبد الله تقريبا للمتعلمين. Because Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, when he was doing that, and he was reciting إن شجرة الزقوم طعام الفاجري, it was to bring the meaning closer to the students. وتوطئة منه له للرجوع إلى الصواب واستعمال الحق والتكلم بالحرف على إنزال الله وحكاية رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. So Abdullah ibn Mas'ud رضي الله تعالى عنه was doing that to make the people understand the meaning. It was تفسير وتوضيح للفظ القرآن. It was to explain the meaning in that. What does the word al-athim mean? Al-athim means al-fajr. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud is explaining it. Like Abdullah ibn Mas'ud was not saying that this word can be changed with this word as they have the same meaning. Nah, he didn't say that. Inshallah ta'ala, I hope this response is enough to prove that what they have brought forward is Oham min Bayt al-Ankabut. Their doubts are very weak. And وَكَمْ مِنْ عَائِبٍ قَوْلًا صَحِيحًا وَآفَتْهُ مِنَ الْفَهْمِ السَّقِيمِ. How many people, they criticize someone's statement, they criticize the Qur'an, they criticize, but the problem is not with the Qur'an, it's their weak understanding. It's not grounded. They just don't have what's needed to understand. So we ask Allah to guide them, if He wants to guide them, and if Allah doesn't, may Allah show us in these people His ability and strength and destroy them and bring them to an end. But if He wants to guide them, subhanahu wa ta'ala, and it's written for them guidance, then may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide them to the religion of al-Islam. Anything which I have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me and shaytan. And Allah and His Messenger are both free from it.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. How can you do a 2-second action right now that will give you a share of the reward of everything we're doing on this YouTube channel? Simple. Like this video and click subscribe. Why? It will allow YouTube to recommend our videos to other users. And imagine the huge amount of reward that could be waiting for you on the Day of Judgment if you did that with a sincere intention of spreading the Deen of Allah. You'll be rewarded for every single person who benefits from one of our videos as a result of your like or subscribe. That's an easy 2-second action that you definitely don't want to miss out on. Do it now, click like and subscribe, and don't forget to make that intention.